Hi. Welcome to our show.
Big one?
Well, that's moist. Yeah, probably. No, no, no. What do you think? Yeah, let's use a little one. This one's old. Right. This is crisp and new. All right, let's go ahead and start this, baby.
Do you want to get the wax going first or wait until we're on camera?
We'll wait and we'll do it on camera and we'll show how to do it. Now, can the string be in there with it?
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
We're just kind of messy.
Yeah, exactly. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. We're going to show you how to make some candles today.
Everybody knows that candle making is where it's at.
You could put it on eBay. You could put it in your Etsy shop. We're going to show you how to make some real money.
Just that easy.
We're going to show you how to make your own candles that you can sell. Candle making is a lucrative business for many artisans around the world.
All right.
That's cool.
How you guys doing?
Hey everybody.
Welcome back to our show.
I thought we were going to say welcome back.
Okay. Welcome to our show.
Welcome to our show about candle making.
We got the handle on the candle.
Yep.
So what we're going to show you today is how to make a candle. All of you out there are probably, some of you are familiar with the process, but we're going to go ahead and show you step by step how to make a candle.
Let's give you a little rundown on things you're going to need. Cardboard, packing tape, a saucepan and deep fryer, which acts as a double boiler. It's actually really boiling. Let me turn this down a little bit.
Turn it down a little bit.
It'd be a little bit of a hazard. Safety glasses or some sort of protective eyewear.
Mm-hmm.
An apron.
Only thing we don't have today, which we should have had, is some kind of oven mitt. But we've got the next best thing, which is a pair of pliers, which will give us a little bit of... So he can do this, grab it, drop it in. But let's get started right away. So we've got the water boiling in the pot separate. We've got the can, and we've got the candles, as you can see. Let me show you each kind of candle. We've got one, which is the emergency or classic candle. It's just a white candle, pretty classic. The tea candle, which is in the aluminum. But the thing about the tea candle is it's a little cleaner because you could take out the wick if you want. So that way it's just the wax versus the emergency candle, you're gonna have to deal with the wax. Yeah. I mean the wick, isn't that right, Chris?
That's a good point. You can fish the wick out with an old coat hanger, or you leave it in for looks.
You can leave it in.
Gives it that shabby chic look.
And it's interesting when that shows up, it starts burning. But we've also just got crayons.
So you'll need these items to make the candle.
You don't have to have all of them necessarily.
No.
But we're going to show you some cool things to do with the crayons because that'll add some color to the white wax. Now also a fun little trick is a birthday candle. We've got a handful of birthday candles here. We've got the emergency candles. We've got the tea candles. We've got the crayons. I've already taken the paper off the crayons to save some time on this episode itself. So we'll
be really careful taking the paper off. I usually use a blade like a... X-Acto blade or something, but you want to make sure you
I just
don't
use my slip. Thumbnails, and it kind of gets your thumbnails all colored, which
waxy.
Is fun too, a little waxy. I think we're basically good to go. Oh no, let's go ahead and show you how we're going to get the candles melted here real soon. But what Chris has done before the show started, just to save some more time, he's taken cardboard squares, constructed them in a way where it turns them into a box. Now the thing about this box is we've went ahead and put the wick in prior to this episode. So what you can see here is there's a piece of string taped to the bottom, drawn to the top, wrapped around a popsicle stick. That'll keep it that way. It'll be in there once you actually put your...
I also added a piece of packing tape to the popsicle stick so it wouldn't slide and fall in. Well, yours is a little smaller so it won't fall in.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure that's secure. We have actually a little fire hazard here I'm a little worried about. So
we've got some
crayon wrapper shavings.
Put them to the side.
Put them in your area.
All right,
maybe
so
some
let's
of
get
this cardboard. We want to get out of the way too. We just don't want any fire hazards in the candle making studio.
Let's get started on some melting some wax. So we're gonna use this can today. We've got the pot boiling. We plugged it in, and we're gonna put some wax in the can. Is that right?
Put some stuff in
so
there.
So let's go ahead and get the tea candles because we could take the wick out.
It's gotta be heavy enough to sit on the bottom of the double boiler because this is half full of boiling water. So you don't want the can floating around. gotta be.
Now, I made it pretty clear, but just so you know, I've got the aluminum around it. You gotta get rid of the aluminum. Take out the wick.
This is actually recyclable.
Take out the wick, drop the cube in. Now, you can get these at your store for like a dollar, maybe two, but it's just the tea candles, I think that's what they're called. They're really basically...
Go to your local dollar store.
Or your Dollar Mart, or...
If you're in Europe, go to Pound Store.
Go to Pound Store. So, what we're going to do is recycle new candles and make them a little bit more handcrafted. What do you think? Is that enough?
You might throw in some crayons.
Let's throw in a couple blue.
Break them up, though.
Break them up? Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, break them up.
Maybe a purple, maybe a black, just to kind of mysterious.
I know that you're going with all the cool colors.
I am going with cool colors today.
Cool guy.
It just matches the set and everything else. We've got...
all right, can I dump this
in? Let's put it in there. We're going to go ahead and get it melting. What is that pot boiling at? What temperature?
Right now, I have it simmering at 275 degrees.
275, and it's at a boil. It's rolling boil even, so we're okay.
Okay, well, it's floating. It's not quite heavy enough, but I think it's going to be fine. I'm going to actually keep an eye on it with my pliers.
Let's take a look. Now, this is the fun part. The kids love doing this. You love watching it melt.
Now,
be careful
right
keeping
away.
Back
it's
from
melting.
The heat, but it's already melting. This is going to be cool. This is going to be really cool.
Yeah, careful.
I just want to take a look.
All right.
Now, I noticed there's some water in there, or is that the actual... No, that's the wax. Wow,
that's
amazing. So we're going to take just a minute here and let that boil. Now, what I've added today is we've got... Basically, unscented wax.
Essentially, what happens is the wax is in a solid form, and it slowly transitions into a liquid, which is the liquid you saw in the can.
Now, what I've done, we've got unscented wax, crayons, and tea lights, and emergency candles. So there's no scent in it. Now, what we love to do is add aroma to you. You want to have something smelling nice in your apartment, in your home, in your studio.
These are great for date night. You can pick up a... bottle of Chianti and Moscato, and then you have your homemade candles and you can just make a night of it.
So what I've done is I went ahead and covered the label so you don't know what it is, but basically this is air freshener of some sort in a can. So it's a spray kind. Now what I'm going to do is go ahead and spray some into my box. That way, it'll smell good.
Just a little. Wow.
It'll smell good.
Just a little.
When we burn the candle. Now that's like a, I don't need
to. Hey, these homemade candles are great. Everyone has a little bit of body odor, so you can put a couple homemade candles in your bedroom and light them. It'll covers up body odor scent.
This is like a
pet scent.
I don't know what smell that is, but it's fresh. So we'll put that in the bottom of your box. We'll put wax in, and I'll go ahead and spray some more in later. That way,
I'll deep fry in my kitchen, and then it has that for like 3 days later. I walk in, I'm like, oh, it smells like fried food in here. Mm-hmm. But not with the homemade candles. Once you light a homemade candle with a little bit of scent,
it's gonna.
You just take this. You want to make sure it's pointed at the candle. Whoa, that's some foam. Just give it a spritz.
So,
all right, we're getting.
So you want to add a good inch. At the bottom of just the spray. Maybe a half inch, it looks like. But sometimes it's a little potent, maybe wear a mask. But so you kind of learn from our mistakes.
This is happening very quickly, so.
Okay, well, how's it look? How's the crayons look? Now, the crayons might melt at a different temperature, so you go ahead and let it all become liquid. Let me take a look.
Yeah, actually, the tea light candles appear
to
be melting the slowest. The crayons went first, the emergency candles went next, and now we're working on the tea light candles. They're pretty dense.
Pretty dense.
You want to pour a little in there?
What, the wax?
Yeah.
No, let's wait a second. You know what we can do?
Put me up with some scent. I didn't get any.
Okay. Now he's got a big box, so we're going to do a lot of scent, so go ahead and cover your...
I'll take a little more. I'll take one more squirt for the road. There's it in here. a little scent, a little bit goes a long way.
That's good.
And we're ready. We're ready to roll here.
We should have been.
All right. You ready? I'm getting dizzy.
It's all the aerosol. All
right. Stand back.
I'm first? Yeah. Okay, stand back. You don't want to burn yourself. You got to be careful. This is going to be fun. This is a lot of fun. Look at it. It's a blue color.
It's blue.
Because we've added the blue candles, the black candle, and then I think we added one purple candle. I can't remember. Keep adding.
Yeah, it's trans.
Can you add a little more?
Yeah. Oh.
Uh-oh.
That's okay. It's okay to have a little texture. All right.
So now we're going to let this dry, and then we'll show you what to do next. So we'll come right back. So we're back now. I've got mine poured. We're waiting to melt his. I'm going to show you real quick. Again, we've added scent at the bottom of it. We want to add more scent because we want this to be throughout the candle. So why it's liquid. Liquid. You want to add more. So let me go ahead and do that.
I also want
to... Oh, ow!
You all right?
I'm okay.
No pain, no gain. Also, the scent acts as a release agent for the wax.
Ah!
Careful. Eventually, what we're going to do is we're going to score and peel the cardboard off.
So wear gloves.
Yeah, wear gloves. The scent acts as a release because it kind of greases the cardboard a little bit. That's probably good.
So we'll be back. We're going to pour his. Let them dry a little bit. Put scent in his.
It's like toothpaste in a way.
Yeah.
When you the Pulled spittle up. After you brush your teeth. Mm. Yeah, I got one roasting over here, and then we'll peel it off.
Mm-hmm.
Hey everybody, welcome back.
You melt the new candles into the can, boil it, liquefy, pour it into your box, wick on top. You wait for it to dry. Now this took us, how long do you think? 20 minutes, and some of it was sitting outside.
Yeah, at least 20 minutes.
And it's like 5 degrees outside. So it could take you a little while, maybe put it in your freezer, let it set for 30 minutes. Maybe that'll be enough.
You
want to
be careful. You don't want to cut the cardboard when you have the molten hot wax, because it could spill on you.
And it could burn your hands.
All right, next step is you want to cut off the popsicle stick.
I'm going to go ahead and do it.
That's your wick. Careful, go back and forth.
It's a little soft. We'll see if our wax is melted. Uh-oh.
Should be fine.
Okay. So I cut off the popsicle stick so you can see I've got the wick. The wick in there. Now this is exciting. This is cool. So we've got the air freshener. I went ahead and sprayed some more in there. I sprayed some more in his while it's still liquefied. It hardens, so now it should be... It actually does smell really good.
Now you want to cut the corners. Be very careful.
Of your box. Of your basically mold. This is a mold.
Yeah, good point. All right, so I'm cutting the box.
Careful right there. Look, it looks a little liquefied still. I'm going to be curious if yours makes a really big mess.
No, that's fine.
Maybe leave the box, the bottom of the box. Oh, wow, dude.
It worked.
Oh, my God.
I don't think I see this. I'm just using a
knife. Here, move this to the side here. There.
Sorry. I'm using a knife, and I'm just cutting.
That is great.
And then what I want to do is the wax and the... scented
the wax there.
That's fine. The scent actually acts as a release for the mold for the cardboard. It's not entirely dry, so I'm going to use my popsicle stick to slowly pry the wax away from the cardboard, and it should.
This is cool.
Yeah, this is actually really cool. It should drop down.
Oh my gosh! It worked out perfectly. It looks
there
like
there you
for
go.
Me.
Yeah, mine too. Mine's still very hot though, so I'm gonna actually.
Mine's a little soft.
I'm gonna let this form a little.
But it gives it a great shape. I don't have a lighter to light ours, but just take our words for it.
Yeah.
Candle.
Oh wow.
So we took an old candle and made a new candle.
Now that is something you would buy at a craft fair.
You could charge a lot for this. Probably.
You could probably charge a lot.
I would charge $20
at least.
So.
Yeah, so you learned a really good...
Yours looks great, too.
Yeah, mine looks really
good. The burn time on this, I don't know, what do you think? Probably 20 minutes, maybe? 5?
Yeah.
5 minutes?
15.
15 minutes?
We'll call it 9 minutes.
Wow, that's pretty potent, too, so this is going to be great.
Yeah, it's very, very fragrant.
So we look forward. If you guys have some, go ahead and post them on our Tumblr page. Tweet us or Facebook us or email us at wacomtx@gmail.com
or Instagram. As well. We like all the social media.
So we want to see your candles. So that was your handle on a candle.
Thanks for watching.
We're going to show you how to make some candles today.
Everybody knows that candle making is where it's at.
You could put it on eBay. You could put it in your Etsy shop. We're going to show you how to make some real money.
It really is just that easy.
We're going to show you how to make your own candles that you can sell. Candle making is a lucrative business for many artisans around the world.